Here's how to add a navigation menu to your WordPress dashboard. And there are a couple of different ways, and I'll show you both of them. Let me know in the comments below, what do you think is the most important features to have in your menu? The first way is pretty straightforward. You can go to your WordPress dashboard, go to Appearance, Menus, and you should see this. If you don't, then the next method I'll show you will show you how to do it. But you want to click on Menus, and these are all specific to your themes. Right now I have theme 2020 installed and activated for my site, so these menu items are specific to my theme. If you go under Manage Locations, these are all the locations where any menu you create can go. So yours might look a little bit different, but we can go to Edit Menus. Let's create a new menu so I can show you what it looks like. I'm going to give it a name. And once we click Create Menu, then we have all of these items over here that we can use. Now by default, it'll show most recent, but to view all of your pages, you can just click on View All. Same thing with posts, View All, and you'll see all of them. And now we can start adding them. So say we want to add Home, Donate, and a sample page. Click Add to Menu. And let me know in the comments below, do you have a Home link in your menu? You can also add, maybe you have a popular post you want to add. You can do that here. Custom links. So if you want to add your social media profile, you can do that here or create a whole new menu for that. We'll do that. Bring that over. You can also do categories. So if you view all categories, these are all the topics on your site that you like to showcase. So maybe we'll bring in a couple of those as well to our menu structure. Now we have all these menu items over here that we can work with. So we can left click and drag these up to rearrange them if you have a better idea of how you want this to look. And you can even do a sub menu, meaning only will show when you hover over the main menu. So when you see when I'm left clicking, bringing that in, there's an indent for that. And so that will only show, it'll be basically a drop down. I'll show you what that looks like. So I like how this looks. This seems a little bit long. You can change that. If you expand any of these items, this is the navigation label that comes from the page title itself. But I don't want all of that, so I'm going to change this. Maybe it's our About Us page. And so that will probably look a lot better on the menu area. And then menu settings, you can choose all of those on where to display the location. So for this one, we want to display it on our horizontal menu desktop. That's like our primary. So I'm gonna click Save. If you forget to do that here, you can always come under Manage Locations and choose the location that you want these at. So now when I open up the site, I can see this is my navigation menu now. And this is the news. When I hover over it, there's the dropdown for YouTube. So now that we've done all that, maybe you go in there and you decide, okay, I don't want YouTube on here. I actually want a separate social media menu that I'm gonna put in a different location. So I'm gonna come back in here, expand this, and instead of changing the navigation label, I'm gonna just click remove. I need to make sure I save that, and now I will no longer have that YouTube part on there. So that's a quick way to remove menu items from there as well. The other cool thing about these is we can go to widgets, and depending on what kind of widget you have on your site, like if you have a footer widget and you want to put a menu item in the footer section, you can do that. You can also do it in the sidebar area. Just come into widgets, click add new, and start typing in menu, and you see navigation menu. So I want to put this in my footer area. I'm going to pick my social navigation menu, and when we click update, now when I go to the bottom where my footer is, where my widgets area are, I see my get social, and then this is my menu here. But what if you're not seeing this menu item under appearance? That's probably because you have a full site editing theme installed. With WordPress 6.0, they have started to allow full site editing. I will switch to the 2022 theme just to show you what this looks like. So let me come in here, I'll activate 2022, and now my theme, there's no area for editing and no area for menu. No worries, we can go to editor and click on editor, and then from here we can make our changes. Now you can click on these and you can click on any part of this, but your main goal is to click on select navigation. It's the little compass looking item, and then you have select menu. So from here, these are the menus that you can choose from. You also have, if you have some from previous, then you have the classic menus, and then you can also create a new one or manage menus. Let's create a new menu. So let's start from empty. So from here, we want to start to pick them up on which one we want. So you can either choose any of the pages or posts. Once you're finished with it, you can click save, and now you have a menu item up here as well. And let me know in the comments below, are you using the full site editor theme for your current website? And if you're wanting to get even further with this and get something like a mega menu, it's something that WP Beginner we use on our site as well, then take a look at this video as I walk you through step by step on how to add a mega menu to your WordPress website. And I'll see you over there.